agenda tonight is case 1704, and I'll go ahead and read the notice. The Zoning Board of Appeals will hold a public hearing in the Selectmen's Meeting Room at Town Hall, 16 Lowell Street, Reading, Mass., on Thursday, May 18, 2017, at 7 p.m. on the petition of Christopher Wicken, who seeks a special permit under Sections 532 and 5472 of the zoning bylaws in order to construct a two-story addition, 18 by 22 feet, with a platform and stairs, as per plot plan on the property located at 128 Howard Street, Reading, Mass. Unless there's an objection, I'll dispense with the reading of the abutters list, except to say that the abutters were notified, as were the appropriate boards and committees in town, and the planning boards of surrounding communities. Testimony given before this board is taken under oath, so if you think you may want to speak, please stand and raise your right hand. That would include the applicant. Mr. Wicken?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I would need to swear you in, so you can raise your right hand kindly?
Absolutely.
Thank you, sir. I swear that the testimony given by me before this board will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. The response is I do.
I do.
The floor is yours, sir.
Cool. Thank you. Thanks for taking the time, sir. Happy to hear my case. Just wanted to give you a quick background of myself and my family. My wife Heather and I live at 128 Howard Street. We have an 8-year-old boy and a 3-year-old boy. Been there for about 4.5 years. We lived on Main Street for about 5 years prior to that. Our older boy is at Barrows right now. Hope to stay there and have my younger boy go to Barrows as well. Become very friendly with the neighborhood and all the neighbors. Recently, as our family starts to grow, we're starting to realize we're kind of on top of each other. The original home, small footprint. We have 3 bedrooms, and we're now talking about a third child. So we've discussed that having some added space in the back for another family room, and then an added bedroom upstairs would be very useful beneficial for my growing family. Been working with an architect to create a design that is not detrimental to the neighborhood, that matches what's there and isn't too bulky and doesn't impede too far into my neighbor's yard. So you'll see I've stepped in a few feet from the outside from the existing foundation. I'm here for a special permit because my existing foundation is within the 15. I'll be stepping further in from that. So between having my architect work with me on a design that we think matches nicely in the neighborhood, I've also met with Glenn multiple times, the building inspector, to look at every piece and part of the building to make sure that I wasn't impeding and creating any more infractions. The documents that you all have in front of you, I've made a minor tweak to the plot plan, which in turn changed the architectural drawings. I brought copies for everybody. I highlighted the changes, so they should jump right out at you. Pass them around first. I'll let you all. Do you need one for record? So the cover page is the same plot plan. It's the same surveyor. All he did was he did 2 updates for me. On the back of the house, I had a platform off of the addition that, when Glenn and I looked at it the second time, we realized, oh wait, that's actually, so we can't have platforms sticking out. He goes, let's flip it around to the back of the house. Stairs can stick out, he informed me, along with bulkheads, but platform cannot. So we've changed that. Also, you'll see on the side of my house that we're gonna remove an old concrete cast in place, covered entrance that we don't use anymore. It's been there since I've lived there. I believe it's in original construction. It'll create some more space on that side of the house, and I think it, just taking that off is going to create some nice space between me and the polymers. So really, that's the changes. I also had them add some more dimensions on the plot plan so that you have a better feel for all of the structures, existing and new, and their dimensions and how they are set back. The architectural drawings, all I've done is highlighted that we flipped the landing into the mudroom to the back, so we're no longer sticking out the side, which would have been a problem. And then I also made a note on the elevations that we've removed that side entrance, that existing side entrance on the elevations. So if anybody has any questions, I'm happy to answer them. clear.
All right, I think we're all just taking a minute to look at the new information that you submitted, but we'll open it up to board comments momentarily. Thanks for your patience.
Thank you.
It's pretty straightforward. All right, so we'll start with some board comments or questions, and we'll start with Robert.
Oh, thank you, David. I looked over the plans, went up and took a look at the piece of property there on that. It looks to me as if it's a legal, non-conforming lot, and also the structure itself seems to be legal, non-conforming. Built prior, looked like, according to the assessor's plan, circa about 1930, so prior to zoning on that. And what do you have, 50-foot frontage. S-15 obviously requires 100-foot, and today's also requires 15,000 square feet. He has about 6,000 there, but as I said, it's a legal non-conforming lot. It is what it is. That's what's there.
As are most of those lots in that neighborhood.
Exactly, yeah. A lot of them up there are approximately the same. The proposed construction is to the rear of the property. Won't be actually seeing it for passerbys going by the front at all, so I don't see it's going to be a detriment to the community at all or to the neighborhood. And I see no new non-conformities on there. Yes, there is a non-conformity. It's 14 feet on one side of the house for the side yard setback, 13.7 on the other, but your existing side yard setbacks are less than that. So
not
there's no new conformities. And I know, you know, looking at Glenn's memo here, Glenn had a memo. You might want to read that into the memo.
I certainly will.
You get it.
Yep.
And looking at the notes from the that were submitted with the packet, Glenn had noted that there would be a new plot plan submitted. Evidently, you talked to him about the platform.
I did.
On that. And so that's been flipped around. So it's just the stairs now that extend out. To be honest with you, I don't have any other issues with, I don't have any issues at all with it. It appears to meet the requirements of the bylaw for a special permit in this case.
Thank you, Robert. Kathy?
I have nothing, but I have no further questions.
Great. Sai?
The first thing that got my attention when I read the notice is it referred to 5472. Section of the bylaw, which is for accessory apartments. I assume this is not an accessory apartment.
That's correct, it's not an apartment.
Okay. And without having the benefit of the revised plot plan, I was kind of confused on what Glenn was saying. But he started out not saying it. When he put his first set of comments out on this case, he said only a permit is required.
Right, special permit.
And then he came on and said we got a variance too. And then I think because of the with the revision of the plot plan, I think that's now taken away again.
Right.
So we're only talking a permit.
Right.
That's the way I see it. Okay? So I think it's pretty straightforward. I don't have any further comments.
Great. Eric?
I think it's straightforward. Comments.
Thank you. Nick?
I don't have anything to add.
Okay. I will go ahead and read into the record the email from Glenn Redman. Case 1704. This proposal is to add a two-story addition with a platform and stairs. The proposal does not comply with required side yard setbacks of 15 feet. A special permit is required for the proposed 18 by 20 addition. Variance is required for the proposed platform with stairs as indicated. On April 25th, I requested an updated plot plan relocating the proposed platform and stairs and to indicate the existing front and side entrances not shown on the plot plan dated April 19th. Having read that into the record, that seems to inform and educate all of us that given the receipt of the updated plot plan, removing the side yard encroachment or the further encroachment or the creation of a new nonconformity, that a variance is no longer required. and that this is a straight special permit. I took a ride by, again, the entire neighborhood appear to be the same type of configured lots with similar styled homes. You know, you're, for the most, there's not a lot of room between you to begin with, but, you know, you've got some yard in the back, so take advantage of it where you can. You know, as Robert mentioned, there's no new nonconformity being created. You bumped it in so that you're, while you're still encroaching into the setback, you're not creating a new nonconformity into the setback, or any, you're not increasing the nonconformity that already exists at the with the principal structure. Let's see that I have one. I actually think. I think that's all I have. So the next part of the hearing is to open the proceedings up to public comment. We'll go ahead and do that, and we will close the public comment since there's nobody here. Are there any further comments or questions by board members? So the only thing that's changed is Glenn's advisory letter, where he recommends that a variance be added, but the legal notice only calls for a special permit.
Right.
So I think we've all educated ourselves and are satisfied that this, that we, I guess, that with the provision of the updated plot plan, a variance is no longer required. My question is, where it appears that, and maybe I'll ask this of the applicant, has Glenn seen these new plans?
Glenn has not.
Okay.
I plan to review them with him.
And so my thought is, to get it right, this might also be considered, and I'm not trying to create an issue where there isn't one, but this might also be considered an appeal of the building inspector's decision.
I emailed it to him, so it's possible he opened it up and looked at it. I just didn't sit with him, so I don't have.
It's clear to us.
Sure.
what you're trying to do.
Absolutely.
Given that the building inspector has, in his most recent, this was forwarded to us today, in his most recent letter, he mentions a variance, that a variance is required, and there is nothing in the file to indicate that the building inspector feels a variance is not required. We can surmise from the comment that Glenn adds regarding getting an updated plot plan, relocating the proposed platform and stairs, that upon review of that, he would perhaps agree that they've removed the encroachment that would be the subject of a variance. So, where the notice only calls for a special permit, I'm inclined to just vote on a special permit, but because we don't have anything from the building inspector that says you don't need a variance, I mean, I suppose we can, on our own initiative, perhaps comment that upon being presented with the updated plot plan dated, you know, referenced and attached to the decision, that it was our determination that no further encroachment requiring a variance. You know, we could probably word a motion or word a decision sufficient to cover that base. Everybody think that's okay? Or do we think we need to stand on more formality?
Well, he was basically saying a variance was required because the location of the platform previously on the side did create,
again,
a new setback.
I'm being a little bit concerned. I understand that, and it's clear to us
that
he's taken that away. I think you're right. I just wanted to raise the issue just in case any other members perhaps had different thoughts on the matter. All right. So we'll vote on the application before us. Any further board comment on that before we get to a vote? Okay. So we've closed the public hearing. No further comments from the board. I'll entertain a motion.
Christopher Wicken, who seeks a special permit under section, I'm gonna go with 7.3.2, that seems to be the one that applies here, of the zoning bylaws in order to construct a two-story addition, 18 feet by 22 feet. And we will omit the platform and stairs within the legal notice since that's not part of the application now. As per the plan, the property located at 128 Howard Street, Reading, Mass., all as depicted on the certified plot plan. I'm gonna go with the one dated May 4th, 2017, prepared and stamped by Edward J. Farrell, National Land Surveyor, and architectural renderings dated April 22nd, 2017, identified as A-1.1 and 1.2, and as further revised in amended renderings dated May 8th, 2017, depicted as A-1.2 and 1.3, prepared by Vision Design and Construction, Inc., 14 Western Ave, Wakefield, Mass. I further move that the board make a finding that the petitioner's reconstruction, extension, alteration, or formal change is not substantially more detrimental to the neighborhood than the existing non-conforming structure. Unless anyone has anything to add to that, I'll just condition it on the usual things. Petitioner shall, the special permit is conditioned on the following. Petitioner shall submit to the building inspector a certified plot plan of the proposed construction and proposed foundation plans prior to the issuance of a foundation permit for the work. Petitioner's final construction plans for the new structure shall be submitted to the building inspector, along with the as-built foundation plans prior to the issuance of a building permit. And as-built plans showing the completed construction of the new structure shall be submitted to the building inspector immediately after work is completed and prior to the issuance of an occupancy permit.
Do we have a second?
Second.
Sigh. Any discussion? All those in favor? None opposed? Your permit is granted, sir. Hang back for a minute. I'll need to stamp that updated plan as approved, and I'll hand it off to you. You'll hang on to that to attach to the decision that the board will render, and that'll be recorded at the Registry of Deeds with the plan.
Thank you.
Eric, just these two sheets are referenced as elevation drawings?
I had all four. I had the originals and the amended renderings. We got the same thing.
All right, A11, A12, A12 amended, A13.
I have them 1.3, 1.2. I think that's how I have them styled.
Okay.
It seems to be.
Oh, it's 1.3. Sorry, I missed the dot in between it. Got it.
sir, your plans are ready for you to take with you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.
Take care. Thank you. All right. The next hearing on the agenda tonight is a continuation of the public hearing in case 1703. Ms. Proia. I'll just go ahead and read the notice into the record. Continuation of a public hearing in the Selectmen's Meeting Room at Town Hall, 16 Lowell Street, Reading, Mass. On Thursday, May 18th at 2017 at 7 p.m. on the application of Rachel Proia, pursuant to Mass General Laws, Chapter 48, Section 9, for a special permit for an accessory apartment under zoning bylaw sections 4.4, 532, and 547, pursuant to Mass General Laws 48, Section 6, for a variance from zoning bylaw section 5473B for property located at 62 Belmont Street in Reading, Massachusetts. All right, you're still under oath, Ms. Proia, and I see that we've gotten some updated information, and you did your homework, in other words, that we assigned from last time. And is there anything you'd like to add that we didn't hear last time?
You'll see in the updated plans that I have a letter from the engineer about the moving the driveway. We don't need the selectmen's approval for that. I have as well a letter from Glenn stating that it conforms to the bylaw. And I've also given you a big plan so you can actually see the side. So I apologize for the last time. The house is so long, it's hard to fit in paper. So for Glenn's instructions, what I've done is highlighted the accessory apartment versus the primary dwelling. And there's a sheet there with Glenn's calculations of the square footage.
That sheet stapled to the bottom is Glenn's
yes.
calculation?
Yes, correct.
Okay, so have you met with the town engineer to get sign off on the new drive, moving the driveway over?
Yeah, there's an email. It should be in your packet. I have a copy here.
Okay. Yeah, I did see that. Okay, I did see it. All right, you need that back?
Do you need it?
Okay. Are there any board comments? Start with Nick.
None.
Eric?
Only that the project appears to comply with all the requirements for the payment standards. We can certainly go through those if we want to.
Sure.
Just the bylaw here.
Page
37,
I think,
Eric. There you go.
Yeah.
Thank you, Rob.
Open this up. While he's looking that up, I'd also like to note that I didn't mention before, the current existing house does not meet the setback requirements. It's only about 11 feet in. The new structure would, so it would actually become conforming to the setbacks.
That's good news. So we've got a couple criteria that we go through for special criteria. First is that only one accessory apartment per lot may be created. Accessory
yes.
apartment shall be a complete separate housekeeping unit containing both a kitchen and a bath. I think you're good with that. accessory apartment shall have a gross floor area not to exceed the lesser of 1,000 square feet, or one-third of the gross floor area, which Glenn has done the math for us on that, so we're all set there. At least one of the owners of the lot, containing both the principal single-family and accessory apartment, shall reside in either the apartment or the principal dwelling.
That's me.
I know if you're saying you're gonna live in one of them.
Mm-hmm.
Accessory apartment and any modifications shall be designated so that the appearance of the principal dwelling remains that of a single-family dwelling, and that any new entry to the accessory apartment shall be located on the side or the rear of the principal dwelling. I see in your plans you have a single front door and access, on the side or in the rear. All stairways to the primary entrance should be to an entrance located on the second or third story shall be enclosed within exterior walls. You're fine there. When there are two or more entrances that already exist on the front facade, that one doesn't even apply because you only have one. All motor vehicles owned or maintained shall be parked off-street. You've got the driveway for that. Both the single-family dwelling and accessory apartment shall be connected to the public water and sanitary sewer systems. I'm sure you're all set with that. Accessory apartment may not be occupied by more than three people, nor have more than two bedrooms, and three people are going to live there.
Just my mom.
So there. J doesn't apply because you don't have a carriage house or barn. And K doesn't apply because we're not giving any waivers for any of the other criteria. In my opinion, you've met all the criteria for this performance standard. Thank you. That's all I have.
Si, any comments?
I just go back to Mr. Cole's memo.
I'm sorry, which one?
It's engineer.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he made a mention of here. But in here he says, in addition to adding some additional information to the plan, I'm not sure exactly what that additional information is. I assume it's just stuff that you presented.
Yeah, he wanted to see, in order to get the driveway permit, you have to have the trees and the elevations on there, which... in order to apply for it, so that's what he needed to add, just so that he can see what's there. But the issue, to get a selectman's approval, he said you need to have driveways 24 feet or greater, and this is only 22 feet wide.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, the other thing I also said in here is that I advise her to have the engineer show the existing driveway on the plan with notation that it'll be abandoned or eliminated.
Correct. And, yeah, so the existing one will be. There's a town tree there. It's a shade tree that we can't remove. Mm-hmm. And it's digging things up, and it's too narrow.
It's on the left side.
It's on the current left side.
Current
so
left side.
We're moving it to the
right
side. Correct.
Yeah.
So it won't obstruct the tree.
It's not on the drawing, but I frankly don't have. I personally don't have a problem with that because we can make a note of that.
Condition for it.
Yeah. Condition. So I don't have a
good.
Good.
Kathy.
I don't.
Robert.
I think you've covered it. I would agree with the other board members. What's been presented seems applicable in this case for a special permit for accessory apartment. Only question, you do have in your plot plan your proposed driveway going on the
right side
of the lot, north side, I guess you could. And that's the one that you're discussing with the town engineer in regards to curb cuts, etc.
Correct.
You have a curb cut on the left side of the existing drive.
Mm-hmm.
So there's one on the right hand side.
Correct.
Okay. And I think that's pretty much it. I think that meets the criteria. I think there was a question in regards to drive all motor vehicles should be parked off street and designated driveway areas, etc.
Yeah, and there's plenty of room there.
No further questions. I'm satisfied.
Okay, we have, well, we did get both in our packet today as well as in an email we got today, we have some comments from Glenn that I'll read into the record.
Yeah.
Case 1703, 62 Belmont Street. This proposal is to demolish an existing single-family dwelling and to construct a new single-family dwelling containing an accessory apartment. This accessory apartment requires a special permit under 5472.
I have reviewed the revised plans, and the new proposal does comply with the area requirements. See my formal letter of denial. Letter of denial dated 5/17/17. To Ms. Proya, I have reviewed your revised plan drawing 3.1 and 3.2 dated 5/11/2017. Your building permit application to demolish the existing single-family dwelling and to construct a new single-family dwelling with an accessory apartment is hereby denied. Section 5472 requires a special permit for an accessory apartment to be constructed in a new dwelling. Your proposal indicates a principal single-family dwelling, two stories containing 2278 square feet. The allowable accessory apartment is 2278 square feet times 33%, or 752 square feet allowed. Your proposed accessory apartment is 746 square feet, therefore is allowed. So it appears you've done your homework. And the updated plans, the getting with Glenn, getting all the stories straight, if you will, wasn't 100% clear to us last week, appears that now we have before us an application from the building inspector's position that we're being asked to grant you a special permit for an accessory apartment only.
Correct.
And no longer being asked to grant a variance. Again, I note, and again, we talked a little bit about this last time. The legal notice recites that the applicant has applied for a variance. In the interest of setting the record straight, I think it makes sense for us to ask the applicant to withdraw their application for a variance, because you don't need it.
Correct, and I thought I did that last week. Is there a different way I need to do that?
Did we do that last week? I don't think so. We didn't take any action on your case last week.
Okay.
We just continued it. Yeah. We suggested doing it that way if we were to,
okay.
You know, as we, you know, we tried to think some of it through. But we ought to do that, I guess, and then perhaps then vote on the special permit in order to make sure that because the notice asks for a variance, we shouldn't just ignore it. We should have something in the file that says you applied for it, you didn't need it, you withdrew it, we voted on the special permit for accessory apartment. So, other than that, I have no further comments. Anybody in the public like to make a statement? Hearing none, I'll close the public comment portion of the hearing. Any further board commentary or questions? Go ahead.
Yeah, just so, is the town asking you to do anything with the old curb cut? Like fill it in or?
They haven't told me that, but I would want to anyway. I wouldn't want an extra, it won't look nice.
Okay, so any more comments from the board? All right, hearing none, I will, I guess let's start with a motion to withdraw the request for a variance. And so the applicants made known to the board that they would like to withdraw their request for a variance. We typically do that via a motion and a vote of the board and a quick write-up saying that the applicant wanted to withdraw. Do we have a motion? Mueller?
I'll make a motion.
Okay,
that,
Robert.
That the board approve the applicant's request to withdraw her, the applicant's request withdraw her variance application for case number 17-03, property located at 62 Belmont Street.
We have a second?
Second.
Kathy, second. Any further discussion? All those in favor? Okay, that part of the petition is withdrawn. Any further board questions regarding the application for a special permit for an accessory apartment? Hearing none, I'll entertain a motion on that application. Robert, want to have at it? Or Cy?
Okay.
I'll take it and write it up. I'll make a motion that the Board of Appeals approve the application for a special permit for an accessory apartment under zoning bylaws section, in this case, 5.47. For the property located at 62 Belmont Street in Reading, Massachusetts. Applicant being Rachel Freya. Is that right?
Freya.
Freya, okay. And this will be in conformance. We did have a plot plan submitted. I have that. In accordance with the plot plan, prepared for 62 Belmont Street extension, prepared by LeBlanc Survey Associates, Anders, Mass., dated February 16th, 2007. And stamped by Vernon J. LeBlanc, professional land surveyor. And in accordance with, I believe we have some architectural plans. Now, we get some new ones tonight. Of the actual superstructure of the house. And number three, a approval of the building inspector or a plan of the as-built construction of the house will be submitted to the building inspector at the immediate end of construction and prior to the certificates of occupancy permitted or given by the building inspector.
Do we want to add a specific condition regarding the approval by the town engineer of the driveway?
Sure, yeah.
The other one I was going to talk about was that they wanted to show the existing driveway and that it was going to be removed.
Right.
And make that a condition as well. I don't know
if we want to make it a condition, though. It appears from the letter that I see from the town engineer that it's kind of being taken care of internally.
Well, I think we should still condition for the town engineer's approval.
Okay.
And town engineer's approval will include the request made, in the town engineer's letter. So
right.
If we just condition for town engineer's approval.
The proposed driveway shown in the plot plan.
Correct.
That's in. So fourth condition being that the town engineer permit the new driveway curb cut and dead end the old curb cut that's there. Okay? All in accordance with his letter that was dated in the CD. May 15th, 2007.
Okay, do we have a second?
Second,
Kathy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor? Your permit is granted, 500.
Thank you.
Hang out for a bit, let me stamp these drawings so you can take them with you. Thank you for your patience.
No, thank you, I know it's never been.
All right, Robert, you read into the record the plans dated February, the stamp drawing, February 16th, 2017?
Si has it written down.
Yeah, you did.
February 16th, all right, just wanna make sure I'm stamping the right ones.
I circled all the architect.
Very good, thank you, Si.
And those architectural drawings are all these. Did you make reference to these newly received ones that we got?
Yes.
All right, good, now I got.
I had the old ones, except the date, the revised, revised date on.
Yep.
So, 2-1, 2-2, 2-3.
What's the date on?
Revision date.
There's a new set with 5/11.
A new set of these. Thought I was taking from a new set, all right, maybe I have right here.
See, the new set has.
5/11. 5/11?
Yeah.
Yes.
Sorry. All right, Ms. Peroya, these are for you. Thanks again.
Thank you very much.
I guess we just have some minutes. Andrew, have a chance to take a look at those minutes. Got April 6th and April 20th.
Right.
I have one proposed change to the April 6th minutes. Find it. I'm sorry, it's not the April 6th minute.
I had a couple on April 6th.
Go ahead.
Want me to go ahead?
Go ahead, please.
Yeah, page 3 on that, the next past the last paragraph. Second sentence, Mr. Sorbo explained that 19-foot bump out would be installed. I changed that would to could be. It's not, it's certainly not definite. It's, it was brought up that it could be done. So we change that, Kim. And then on page four, fifth paragraph down, last sentence, the dumpster will fit by the existing retaining wall, not retainer, but if you drop ER and then ING, the retaining wall. And those are the two comments I had on April 6th.
I have one on page six, under other business of the April 6th. Under other business, the second full paragraph, Mr. Trunello said that 40B may not be heard until after February 22nd.
So I'm sorry, other business.
Other business, second paragraph that starts Mr. Redfern.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
After 40B, right below that,
mm-hmm.
instead of would, may. Anybody else? Let's go vote on. All right, we have a motion to approve the April 6th minutes.
So moved.
Second?
As amended.
As amended?
Second.
Second by Eric. All those in favor? Moved. Any comments with regard to the April 20th minutes?
I had a couple of small ones, David. Let's see, first page, third paragraph down starts off, Mr. Redfern said the property is a legal non-conforming lot, but does not meet setbacks. Well, a lot can mean, so what we should insert, take out the word but, can, and insert in the existing structure does not meet setbacks. The property is a legal non-conforming lot and the existing structure does not meet setbacks. Okay? And to end that paragraph, he said the proposed garage would create a non-conforming setback situation, not a non-conforming lot, but a non-conforming setback situation. And on page two, I hate to put words in John's mouth. I know he's not here tonight, but it's the fourth paragraph. Mr. Jurema said he's having difficulty with the first two criteria. He questioned the location of the ledge and why the proposed garage could not be decreased in size. If we could put decreased in size to meet the 15-foot setback, period. Take out the word in the rear. I think we were talking from the side yard setback for that garage. Those are the comments I have on that meeting.
Any other comments?
One paragraph on page two down where it says, Cobet asked how close the existing sheds were to the property line. In the second sentence, he did not know, but one of the shed, it should be plural.
All right, motion to approve. Do we have a motion to approve the minutes?
I move to approve the minutes of the April 20 meeting as amended.
Second?
Second.
Kathy? All those in favor? Minutes are approved. No other business on the agenda tonight. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Second from Kathy. All those in favor? We are adjourned. Thanks, everybody.